stationed here than in the approach.
Hey, the best keep is in the approach, man.
Let me know if you need a break. I'm all right, thanks.
Oh, and I remember that. Like, these guys just, like, chatting. I like that.
Inquisitor.
River secure.
The Hakkonites were pushed back from the river.
That will put minds at ease, sir. I'll arrange patrols for the area. It's no Imperial highway, but we'll see people along as safely as we can.
Thank you, sir.
That will be all, Lieutenant.
Sir.
Cookies! If Sten were here, that's right. He would have been like, why did you waste the cookies and put them on that? He'd be like, why did you do that?
Making progress.
I could just stand around here all day. Freaking... Does anybody else have problems with somebody wearing the Ring of Doubt? Like, they're an NPC companion? And, like, just not quite responding the way he's supposed to? Or she? Like... he would have taken the cookies. He'd have been like, freaking, why'd you waste them? Don't just leave them there. Alright, let's find the Avar hold now, because that's my favorite. Oh, wait, let's just mark it on the map. Wow, it's far away. We're gonna find so many things along the way. Last time I came here, I actually... That happens for you too, Stone Smith, with Dorian. Or with a mage who wears the Ring of Doubt. Alright, interesting. I wonder why. Because it just says it's gonna cloak them. It doesn't say anything about, like... And then we'll make them not function as well and have to boop to you all the time. Enter stealth. When you automatically attack from stealth, you critically hit. Yeah, that's... Oh, and it's the flanking damage bonus. Right. That's so weird. So weird that it gives me troubles like that. Your Dorian just doesn't move. Maybe it's just Dorian. Nah. Oh, and Frogreard, that's why you don't give it to a companion. I was kind of curious. Because you said you had it for yourself. I mean, it doesn't cause too many problems, I don't think, but... It's just kind of weird. Like, it's not, like, super inconvenient. It's just weird. Jumpy, 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 jumpy. Another reason I love being a rogue is the mobility you are afforded on the battlefield. So yeah, I mean, Dorian's fighting. Who's it? Hang on, I want to see you two fight. Dang it. Sometime, I want to like... Because I know each mage style has like a different, look to it. And I'd like to, maybe... notice that more. Like, they have, like, different move sets, you know? They go into stealth and forget how to walk. Yeah! Ooh, Silverite. Hello. That's what it seems like. What? Okay. Let's see. Hang on, hang on. Foliage, come here, foliage. Yeah, my favorite thing. Honestly, one of my favorite things about this game is that there's bug damage in the leaves. Like, who would normally notice that? Like, who would normally like put that in? Like, because like, oh, no one's gonna notice it. We'll just make all the leaves look perfect and pristine. But you do that, and then it looks sort of unreal. Like, I would assume it would like sort of hit like an uncanny valley type thing, you know? And it would be like, why do the little plants look like a cartoon? You know what I mean? Hollow leather. Wait. I need to go to the Astrariums. I know I need to go to the Avar. There's an Astrarium right there. And there's also an Astrarium back at the beginning. Okay. Astrarium. I have no idea what's in the Astrarium here. At first, I was like, I'm not gonna worry about it, but then with my human noble, I just started doing, like, the Astrariums, and I think they're really cool, and I wanted to get all the codex entries. It's alright. Everywhere. Oh my gosh, I got 2 and 3. Wow. Hi, don't be angry. But yeah. What was I saying? I was saying things about... Shoot, what was I talking about? It's weird when they have companion conversations and are miles away. Yeah. Or like when they're dead and they like say, what's this? Like a fairy circle? Because it's not a fairy circle, because a fairy circle would be an actual circle. This is like a fairy plaza. I feel like something terrible is going to happen in here. Yes, you never noticed the leaves? Yeah. I feel like I was saying something that related to the leaves being cool, but now I can't think of it. Yeah, it's just the little things, and I appreciate the work that has gone into shrooms everywhere. Ooh. Shoot, what was I talking about? Oh, the Astrariums. I was doing all the Astrariums, and that's when I got the prismatic great axe, and I was just like, ah! But I freaking didn't know there was a chromatic great sword. Like, oh my gosh! It's perfect, because Iriko's more of a... She's not like a maul spec. Like, for me, that there's a two different types of two-handed weapons, right? There's like the AoE. Was it the, maybe it'll... Do I have examples? Yeah. Like, this one's just like the maul where it's like... Like, you don't swirl... I mean, you swirl around it a little bit, but, like, the damage is more, like, direct and, like, straight down. But whereas this is, like, a swinging damage, like, an area of effect damage, you know? For, like, a great axe or a cleaver or something. But... I swear the prismatic great axe was, like... Maybe it is just the mauls. I don't know. Oh, that's right. My human noble. I wanted her to be a maul specialist, but like a, not an AoE specialist, but I gave her the prismatic great axe because it looked so freaking cool. Your leg is killing. Sorry, Frog Grader. It's time to, for a mu- Ew. I actually don't like mushrooms. Holy freaking crap. Okay. I have never done the Astrariums in this place. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. This is not gonna go well. Nope, I already did it bad. It's right there, maybe. Oh god. Maybe there, and then there. And then, no. Oh god! Oh my gosh. Your tank sucks. Iron Bull isn't a good tank, is the thing. But I mean, you've gotten through the majority of the game, right? So I was like, oh, maybe it's working out for you. If it isn't working out for you, it's because Iron Bull, for whatever reason, is not actually a good tank. He's a damage dealer, but he doesn't have good tanking abilities. So, yeah. I don't envy you. Oh my gosh, there's so many! Risk of something even more magical world with those? With the with the mushrooms! Ha ha! Definitely. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna cheat and I am gonna freaking. I'm gonna look up the Astrariums in the Frostback Basin because I don't want to waste your guys' time. Otherwise, I don't mind just trying to work my way through them. But, Basin Astrariums. Just start at one with an odd number of lines coming out of it. Okay, so, like, this one. Yeah? And it's got three coming out of it. Oh, you're right. I see. Because you'd have to, like, be able to change direction easier. I clicked the wrong one. Dang it! I clicked the wrong one. Okay. be this one. And see, ideally, I would like to go around in, like, there's some sort of order, but there doesn't really seem to be... Wait! It has four? You're right! Whoa! That one has four. That middle one has four. Okay, there's one. I see. Over here. This one's got... Nope, got four as well. Holy crap. Wow. Okay, there's one that has five. This one? One, two, three, four, five. That's five. Oh, the one down and from the left. No, him and Cassandra, they don't do anything to keep you alive. Okay, yeah. Bull isn't the best. Like, I wanted him to be, and I tried to bring him out, but he died so much when I would bring him out. What you have to do with him is if you want him to live, you have to try to choose abilities that beef up his constitution a lot and give him armor that gives him guard. And try to just beef up his constitution as much as possible, especially because he's a reaver, right? And he's that might actually be why his health goes down so quickly. It's because the reaver abilities are actually, like Frog Raider was saying, I didn't really think about it ever, but reaver abilities are actually better when your health is down. So if you get your health down like halfway or a little less, and then you get your guard up, that's when your abilities are the most advantageous. So that's probably why Iron Bull, for whatever reason, he just doesn't keep health very well. Cassandra's pretty good, but if I want to live, I bring Blackwall. They aren't holding aggro? Strange, because Cassandra usually does. Oh, okay, so it's not just that they're just not doing anything to keep you alive. That's weird. Sometimes if they, like, freeze up, that's a problem. I've had that problem before. Where they just, like, stop. They will all have an even number apart from the start and the end. Oh, okay. So this one has five. One, two, three, four. Nope, has six. Okay. Right? Yeah. Oh, it does. Weird. Okay. You said the one when I was... Oh, this one. One, two, three. So this one has three. Okay. Kayuka's like, no, they're fine, they're alive, just, they're not holding aggro. Cassandra usually does, because she's got the, like, challenge abilities and stuff. You might actually want to go into their tactics and see if you have those abilities starred or X'd out. That's the only control you get over your companion's tactics in this game. And it took me a long time to realize it, but I always put Cassandra, I put all my warriors' guard abilities, I star them, so they'll do them as quickly as possible. And sometimes they're accidentally X'd out somehow, and so maybe a couple of their abilities are X'd out, and you need to go in and, like, make them at least have a check mark, if not a star next to them. And Dorian kind of died. Dorian dies. Okay, I'm gonna start there. And go like this. And like this. Oh shoot. Oh, okay. Oh, da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Oh, I'll risk it. Ooh, buddy. I might be backing myself into a corner here. If I could go there. And then down. Up. Ooh, Oh my gosh, this might work. Oh, maybe. Am I doing it right? Oh my gosh. Don't lose track. Okay, I could totally screw myself over on this. I could go like boom, 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 but that would end it. Boom, boom, boom. Okay. So, down, over. Oh my gosh! Yes! Woo! Thank you, Stonesmith! I didn't have to look it up. Your advice was like top notch. That's exactly what you needed to do. Full Menos. The tension! Commonly known as a thunderbolt, the constellation Full Menos depicts a bolt of lightning thrown by a wrathful god. Which god has always been a matter of dispute. Each of the old gods' inventor has been credited as the thrower, with the target being anything from the lost city of Barad-dûr to a jester who made a particularly heinous pun. Nice. Excellent. Let's go grab this little tent area. And then... Oh wait, that might kill me. That's gonna kill me. Okay. Aaron Press, thank you! You love Bull and Cassandra's party talk? Yay, Stone Smith! Yeah, I like that! Little upraised arm of victory. They talk about your butt, Cassandra and Iron... That's right, because you're romancing Cassandra, right? Oh my gosh. They talk about your butt. Oh my gosh. I think I've only had Blackwall comment on my relationship with Dorian. And it wasn't, like, the greatest. It was more like he was just kind of... It wasn't bad, but he was just very surprised. He was like, I didn't think the Inquisitor was... that sort of person. And Dorian's like, do you want me to make diagrams? And I could just see Talon just like silently laughing and shaking his head, just like, oh buddy. Is this the best way to go? Yeah, it's all right, it's cool. That is so funny. I can't wait to romance Cassandra, to be honest with you. I'm gonna make a rogue human noble, and I'm gonna romance the crap out of her. It's gonna be awesome.
There, it's the Lawlanders.
Kill the Inquisitor. Death to his hold for Hakkon's glory.
Nash, nash. Dodgy, 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 dodgy. Oh, shoot. I think we got that one thing involved in our mess. That guy. Solas is fine. Solas is fully capable of taking care of himself. Let me flank you. Dang it. Dang it. That was horrible. Can you link a clip? Yes, link a clip. It should work. People sometimes link pictures. Ooh, there was something I wanted to show you guys. It was a really funny post I saw that basically sums up, like, how freaking many Americans are feeling. Cassandra, I wish you the best. Perfect. There we go. Perfect. Wait, no. That was Cassandra.
Demanding your death. What do they have against us?
It's the friendlier Avar in the village.
I think it basically sums up in that, oh my gosh, we got a bunch of them involved. How great. Detonate it! Detonate it! Nice! I never actually noticed until just like the last time, I think, the motion that Talon makes when he detonates the mark. Get the mark again so I can check it out. Pay it more attention. And then Yeah, he like throws his arm up in the air, like now type thing. That's cool. I like that. Oh my god. Alright, let's just take this moment to observe how Dorian and Solas. Oh, he just did the blizzard, that's what he did. I love seeing Dorian do the flame wall, that's really cool. You're taking a break from trespasser, Ashley? Here, okay, let's keep firing at these guys. Holy crap. Ashley, you've never seen Jaws of Hakkon. Alright, there's a big intro for it when you get here, but we did it. You maybe saw it on the recording on YouTube. Because I ran in here just so I could get the dang nab silverite to craft the Dalish warrior armor for my scout. So much talk of butts. Hey, Ashley, you're just in time to watch the link that talks about butts. Apparently, I need to look at it. I probably can't watch it right now, but I'll link it and then I'll like click it and then pause it so I can watch it later. Yeah, craggy skin. Excellent. Avar Cotton, score! That's right, I should be attacking as many Avar as possible. Inquisibutt, that's the name of the video! That's so funny! Okay, I have the video, but I'll watch it when I'm not. Ooh, I just saw the stream like load for a second. It was like, oh my gosh, why did you make me do that? I worry about my computer. It's like, I'm too old to do these things. There's an ocularium. I should perhaps do the ocularium. Apparently the, I mean, I got all the shards here with Erica. I got all the shards with her. She's the only character I will ever do that, all the shards with, because she's romancing Solas, and it's about the Solasad Temple. Ooh, look, I like this log. It's like a little walkway, like a little half log. I like it. Yo, guys, I'm just gonna set up camp in this tree. Don't come over here. Oh, crap. Oh, god dang. Just let me jump. Nope. Okay. Fine, then. I'll go back to being Talon. No! I love all the greenery, like, just falling all over the thing that things. Well, because they said wood rots faster, right? So the only thing we really should be seeing are Tevinter ruins. We've seen a couple abandoned houses, and we've seen these. So these have to be fairly recent, but I don't know why the Avar would bother with this. I'm gonna save, actually, really quick. I have so many deep road saves. Yay, supplies replenished. Yay. Okay. So we got that Astrarium. And then there's this one. I'm gonna run back and do that one. Oh, good. It's gonna show me. Okay, good. It's gonna show me where the other one is. I'm gonna run back and do that one. Because I really wanna know what the Astrarium treasures are. Because I thought that they weren't that great. But that. And some of them aren't. But you get some pretty cool griffin plate and stuff from them. In a couple of them, and you also get that freaking prismatic great axe, so. And this is freaking Jaws of Hakkon DLC. It better be good. Your current go-to party is Bull, Sarah, and Dorian, the party squad. Oh, good idea. There you go, Frog Raider. You're a night enchanter. So you fight with him. Yeah, I'll get to you later, guy. I'm not really worried about it. I think his was like one of the only quests I didn't do last time. I was just like, boop. Man, there's so many of these little Tuskets around too. There weren't that many in the 360 version. At my old school. I hate that so much. Yeah, Bull and Sarah and Dorian, I'm someday gonna have to make an Inquisitor who would take that squad out, because it's definitely the party squad. Whoa, buddy. Oh, shoot. Oh, okay. Oh, wow. Interesting. It's not on one side, it's different from the other side. It's not exactly symmetrical. Okay. Sometimes there are like extra stars and it really throws me. Oh shoot. You're a snarky elf assassin, Kayuk. But you can't take Sarah. Yeah, I know, right? You're the archer and you can't have too many archers. I know. I'd like to bring Sarah out, too. Sarah's comments on Bull and Dorian being together. I can't actually decide if I want Bull and Dorian to get together for my canon playthrough or not. Because I didn't know that was a thing that could happen. Until, like, way after. But... Oh, shoot. Yeah, I did something wrong. I'll give it one more go. Or actually, it might be better to start up here. Seeker, right? Frog, did you get the chat where Sarah asked Dorian? Oh my gosh. See, in Dragon Age 2, I had the couple squad where it was me and Anders, and then Fenris and Isabella, but not in this game. It was just me and Solas. Known as the one. And now I'm romancing Dorian, right? So there's no options, I guess. Known as the Watchful Eye, in common parlance, this constellation had great significance to the ancient Alamari and Syrian peoples of the southern Thetis. Story goes that the Lady of the Skies opened one eye so that the light from her gaze could lead her people safely from the Frostbacks. When Andraste's armies marched north from their ancestral lands to wage war upon Tevinter, they were guided by the Eye, and they became the Maker's Gaze, not the Lady's, leading them to victory. The sword was added later. It is said that the star that marks the point of its blade only appeared in the night sky after Andraste's death, of course. The early Inquisition took Vistis as a symbol of their holy calling when they joined the Andrastian faith, the Eye representing both their search for Maleficarum and the Maker's judgment upon their actions. the Inquisition ended and became Seekers of Truth, and the Templar Order. The Templars took the sword, while the Seekers retained the eye. Oh my gosh! That is really cool. Yeah, Blackwall and Josie, but I still don't know how to make that one happen. And Josie can't come out, so yeah, you can't have her as part of the couple squad. Wow, though. I mean, the Templars and the Seekers both originated from the original Inquisition, so having them take each a part of the symbol, that's really cool. And it actually makes a whole lot more sense to bring the Templars back into the fold to sort of restart things, because you're just bringing them, like, bringing the sword back into the Watchful Eye. Oh my gosh. Maybe they shouldn't have split in the first place. I don't know. That's really cool, though. What? The only sad bit about Blackwall and Josie is the game always suggests it was your fault they don't get together. Whatever decision you made. I don't even... Like, how do you get that to happen? Like, I have, like, four characters that I've played pretty actively on, and only one of them is romancing Blackwall, and none of them are romancing Josie, and I have no idea how to get that... I don't know if I'd want it to, because I did know that you couldn't get them back... You couldn't... They won't get together, but... Still... Oh, I should grab that right there while I'm here. Opa! More Avar! I don't know if I want to go after the Avar, though. I really do want to go talk to the nice Avar. It can get triggered between Blackwall and Varric or Blackwall... Oh, so if Blackwall and Varric are talking and Blackwall and Cole are talking a lot, then it will, like, somehow encourage Blackwall to, like, go flirt with Josie? With Josephine? That's cool. That's interesting. Yeah, just get the party right and then it's basically a random chance. Interesting. I have so much influence. Oh, that isn't what I wanted to do. Oh, I should do some of the rifts, though. There's a big one out here. Right? Is that... That's out in the middle of the open? Or is that over here? It might be more over here. I do want to go out and do the rifts, though. Because I want to get more goodies. Time to fight some dragons, Caillou. Good luck. Wasn't there a... Yeah. Oh, there's a cave! Oh, that's right! Okay, I know, it's that the landmark is in the cave, that's right. Well, let's go fight this rift and see how that goes. Oh, there is a lootable in there. Spindleweed! Yeah, it's under the thingamajiggy, the landmark is underground. It's a pretty cool cave in there. If it's the one I'm thinking of, it's nice. Solas, how'd you get up there so easily? Was what? Yikes! Priority order 1, loot 2, romance 3, save the world. Yep. Always. Romance is always a priority in freaking BioWare games. Like, that's why people are like, why haven't they shown us any romance options? Like, they've shown you a couple of, like, we've gotten a couple trailers, right? On, the new game, on Andromeda. But none of them really show any of the other characters. And people are like, where's the romanceable characters? I bet you on in 7 days, they're gonna tell us a whole lot more. Yeah, I'm using an ice bow to fight against the despair demons. Despair demons are horrifying. Have you ever seen them up close? It's just, there's no face. It's just mouths and teeth. It's horrifying. There we go. Good. Who is this invisible one right here? I'm gonna throw myself off the back of the cliff. I'm feeling it. What happened to me? You're supposed to be dead. You're like practically dead. Oh, there's a despair demon behind me. That was my trouble. I think Cassandra just knocked the despair demon off the cliff. There we go. Probably got a couple of them. Oh boy, I can't see. Solas, I can't see anything. Are you gonna kill it? Because I can't see it. Dorian is hitting the ground. Ever so useful. Can I put it down on the ground? No, I don't want to go down there. There we go. You dead yet? Okay. Today is a very good day. Nice. Bull is hilarious. Oh my gosh! Savage Thorn. Wow. What even? 414? Holy crap. An inscription on this dagger reads, "Nothing is more savage than the thorn one does not see." Cool! Selling that dagger. Holy crap. Jeez Louise. Oh yeah, I leveled up. Yay. What do I even want? I kind of wanted to get the throwing daggers thing, the throwing blades, but I don't know what I would take out, to be honest. It's starting to get to that point where I'm like, well, I've basically gotten everything fully upgraded. Oh, wait. Oh, I don't have this one fully upgraded or full draw upgraded. Oh. Does even more damage at... That's right. Does more damage at greater range. Or rips along. I think I'll do the damage at greater range. Or enemies hit by full draw are knocked briefly unconscious. Or they're immobilized. See, they can be knocked unconscious, but as soon as you hit them, they wake up, right? Or they could be immobilized for 5 seconds, but does that work on the big guys? Alright, we'll do that one. Excellent. Talon's getting old. Where are the friendly Avar? Oh yeah, they're like way over here. Colette. Yes, we should probably go talk to the Avar. Sarah has some interesting reactions to the Avar hold. Who's that? Oh. I brought her... I think I flipped out her and Dorian a couple times when I was here. And when I brought Dorian, we stumbled upon some Taventer ruins. I was like, oh yeah, Dorian's a really good person to bring here because he's from Taventer. And if there are Taventer ruins here... Yo! What's that? My lord. Shadows. I know there's a shard up here. What? No. What? Oh, it's one of you. Okay. Oh man, we gotta go through like just come
be
on.
Be prepared. There's no telling what trouble we'll find down here.
Oh, and this is where the... Yeah. Could I fight it from up here? Oh, snap. It can still shoot, like, crap at me, though. Oh, can't do it. I think Cassandra's down there. Sorry, Cassandra. Oh, I think the mark of death makes it burn. There we go. Got some shatter damage. There we go, because we're pretty far away, so that probably did a whole freaking crap ton of damage. One more, five more to go for dragons? Nice. I know, I've been hunting a lot of dragons with Talon. Alright, maybe we'll go down there now. Wah. Give me a health potion. Maybe let's see. Nice! Cassandra sounds like she has a bucket on her head. I took the bucket off of her head. Royal elf root. Elf root. I'm hoping I'm not messing up that quest. I'm kind of trying to get, like, a head start on that quest. Right! This is the place where, like... The corpses are massive! Oh, come on, there's Felindoris right here. Okay. Ah. Look at these corpses! They're huge! A true Griffin Feather Charm. Knight's Hunting Blade. Ooh! Masterwork Grey Warden Shield. Shoot! Well, I'm like, look, like, these skeletons are bigger, but look, there's some little ones, right? But these, most of these skeletons are massive. Oh, come on, I thought there was a landmark here or something. I'm not quite sure who this is, I mean, you would think it's associated with the Avar. Oh. Look, that helm, it looks like, well, I mean, it looks kind of like, it looks like the Templar, but it also kind of looks like the helm of the Inquisitor. But it's different than this. This one has, like, these extra soldiers. Oh, unless those soldiers, they're further, this is, like, embedded. And look how massive these sarcophagi are, like, just to hold these guys. The Avar. Yeah, these must be the Avar warriors, like a specific type. And look at, when you bring Cole here, Cole says something really cool. He's like, the trees are angry. And it's like, oh my gosh. Oh, look, more Felindaris. Look at that. I'm rolling in the Felindaris. Does she sound echoey on mine, or like on my end, or on your end? Oh, this is the one. This is the one that...
Over there. We must do something.
Oh yeah, Colette's here! The Bloodstained Shrine. This is some of the scouts. And they hid amongst the corpses here, and the Avar abandoned the chase. They just got here and, like, left. Oh, look, there's, like, freaking dragon eggs. Like, or just, like, something, like, stone carved to look like dragon eggs. So, this must be some sort of, this must be a shrine of Hakkon, then. Because otherwise, the Hakkonites probably wouldn't have respected it as much. Since they've kind of given up the other gods. Holy crap, she's almost dead. I'm sorry, we don't have any, we only have Cassandra as our frontline fighter. She held her own pretty good.
Finding it difficult to breathe, but I'm not strewn across the landscape, so thank you.
She's so cute.
I'm Colette.
She looks kind of like my human.
Kendrick's research assistant. I was hoping to conduct a survey of a Tevinter ruin in the hills. I may not have chosen the best route.
She doesn't have Dalish markings, does she? Nope. I thought she was a city elf, but wasn't sure.
You're Kendrick's research assistant, so that makes you a student at the University of Orlais.
It does. Why?
Orlesian institutions aren't always accepting of elves.
We can't all run inquisitions, but I imagine you've caught whispers behind your back,
too. Of course!
The university accepts those worthy of admission, though elven students are few.
How do you find it there?
It's not easy, but this is what I want. And I like working for Professor Kenrick.
This is good.
Research students, where publications concerned, their work's often deemed not substantial enough for formal credit.
I hate that.
But Kenrick cares about people who want to learn. If our research finds an audience, I know my name will be included.
Of course it would. Kenrick wouldn't even think about it. Of course he'd put your name in there. But it's good for elves to be branching out, like, into other things, like, you know what I mean? Like, they don't all have to be stuck in slums, they don't all have to be wandering the wilderness, trying to find ancient ruins of, like, and she's kind of bridging the gap, right? She's a city elf, but she's finding ancient ruins that aren't necessarily elven, but that, you know, she wants to find ruins just like the Dalish do, and find pieces of history, lost history. It's just done a little bit differently. That's interesting to think about.
What were you hoping to find at the ruin?
The Tevinter's time here was brief, but their architecture endured, offering shelter, forming landmarks.
I'm wondering how this place formed.
Ancient Avar would have encountered these structures, which certainly predate Inquisitor Emeridan. Evaluating the ruins could offer insight into the region's history, once I can get set up.
You're still going there?
I've read everything we have on Emeridan. And studied up on new excavation techniques. I won't waste this opportunity. If you've a map, I can show you my destination. If you'd be interested in the findings.
Yes, I carry maps. I just carry all kinds of maps all over me.
I will.
Is that all?
Yes.
Okay, bye-bye.
Stay safe.
I will.
Stay safe, little researcher. Lurker scales. Poke.